Matthew 4. Then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. And after fasting 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. The tempter came and said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command these stones to become loaves of bread." But he answered, "It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God."
We're in Yosemite.
I speak unto thee this day, and I say there are literally multitudes who despise to see me move. That is, they despise to see me move by my power, by my spirit, by my anointing, for I say they want things their way. That is, they prefer to go on and on and on in the foolishness, the vanity of their own way, thinking they are some great thing. And I say they literally despise to see me move. But I say it is me, the living God, who is nonetheless calling forth for all men to repent. And I say that the fools can go on in their folly. That is, they can go on hating to see me move. And I say that I withdraw myself from them. But I say that the ones who are hungering and thirsting for my power, my strength, my glory in their lives, I say that the same shall be revealed unto them. For I say it is me, the living God, who is able. It is me, the living God, who will bring forth, direct, and correct the ones who are seeking to please me. Now I say this day that I, the living God, am at this time calling for all men to repent, because they are needy of the same. That is, they are needy of turning from their own wicked ways to walk uprightly in the way that I provide. And I say they are needy of coming forth ever uplifted, directed, and ever guided by me. For I say it is indeed a privilege to believe upon me, to receive of me, and come forth in my way. And I say it is a privilege to be knowing that I, the living God, do reign supreme. Now I say you are living in a time when men think it a pleasure to take people up and down and all around in all of the traumas of the day. But I say that I, the living God, do not call thee to be caught up in the traumas of the day, for I say there have always been troubles. That is, as long as the world has been, there have been troubles in the same, because it is ruled by sin. But I say, when any man or woman will be ruled by me, then it is me, the living God, who brings to them the peace that only I can provide. Now I say, when a man is at peace with me, then he does not need to take up the disturbances, the troubles, the calamities of the world. That is, where they're sorely vexed each day and tormented. For I say those things are all a play. That is, there are those who are in power who love to play with the minds of any and all who will yield themselves unto them. That is, they love to play around and mess up the thought life of any and all who hearken to their lives. But I say, if you cleave to me, then I say you are cleaving to the truth, and you will be guided in sound counsel. And I say that you will be given the wisdom that I, the living God, can provide each and every day. For I say it is me, the living God, who is the way of truth, the way of life, and the way of mercy provided. And it is me, the living God, who will ever uplift, direct, correct, and bring forth the people who cleave to me. Now I say, therefore, this day be glad for the privilege to believe upon me, to look to me, and to walk uprightly in me. For I say, if it is me, the living God, that you look to, if it is me, the living God, that you will believe in and trust and obey, then you are brought forth in my way. And yes, you are given the strength, the truth, the light that I offer, for it is me, the living God, who is present to give thee the same. And yes, you will be given the hope and the peace, the strength, the safety, and the truth time and again, for it is me, the living God, who likewise gives that unto thee. For I say, if it is me that you believe, if it is me that you will obey and follow after, then you are directed, corrected, and ever brought forth by me. Now I say that I, the living God, never called my people to the weariness, the dreariness, the darkness of their own way. but I say that I've called my people to be ever believing, to be receiving, and coming forth in me. For I say indeed that I, the living God, will be the one who is ever present to guide forth, to instruct, direct, and correct the people who cleave to me. And I say, when the ones who are mine will be ever present in me, then I say they know the joy of my presence. Now I say, this day the world is full of darkness, evil, and iniquity, but I say again that it is ruled by sin. And I say, wherever sin is in rulership, I say there is all manner of evil. And I say that men yield themselves to the evil, the darkness of the saint, because they have despised the light. And I say they go on waxing bolder in the very sin that is killing them and causing them to be damned forever. And I say that I, the living God, do look upon the sons of men who are caught in the pride of their own stupidity. And I say that I offer unto them the way of repentance revolution. And I say if any man or woman will accept that way, then they can indeed be brought forth in me. And I say that they can indeed be given the truth and the light, the strength, the hope, and the peace each and every day. For I say it is me, the living God, who is the way of all righteousness and truth, the way of all mercy and strength, and the way that is peace providing. Therefore I say, continue ye as a steadfast people who are ever believing and looking unto me. That is, continue as a people who trust in me, believe upon me, and know that I am able. For I say, when it is me that you keep on hoping in, when it is me that you will follow after and seek to please, then you are ever guided forth by me. And I say you are given the strength, the truth, to continue always in the way that I give thee time and again. Therefore I say this day, be glad that it is me that you can continue to look to, that you can continue to believe, to trust, to obey. And I say, be thankful when I, the living God, have put the way of eternal life before thee, that you can indeed be guided always by me. For I say, when you are indeed in the way that I, the living God, do intend, then I say that the world and all of its traumas will not bear rule over thee. But I say, when you get your eyes full of adultery, you crane your neck, and I say you get too busy about the affairs of the world, then I say the same will crush thee. Now I say there are many who started out to follow me, to trust in me, and to obey me. But I say they got too curious about the affairs of the world, and now I say they are crushed under the weight of the same. For I say they lost their desire, their hope in me. I say they lost the vision, and I say they lost their faith in me. And I say all they can do each day is go up, go down, and around by the traumas of the day. Now I say that is a futile and a fearful existence, and I say that it is not meant for the ones who are mine. For I say that my own people are meant to be found abiding each day in me, coming forth in the truth, the light that I provide. And I say that my people are meant to be knowing that in me they are given the hope, the peace, the strength, and the safety each and every day. And I say that the ones who love me and cleave unto me are ever guided by me. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do call the ones who serve me to walk uprightly, to keep single in the vision and ever purposed in me. And of course that takes effort on the part of my people, and I say they cannot grow lazy along the way. For I say, wheresoever you see a man or a woman who is lazy in their spiritual life, know they are setting themselves up to be deceived. And know they are setting themselves up to be led astray from my way, because they do not keep active in the warfare against sin. Now I say this day that when a man or a woman will close their eyes and hope that sin will go away, it absolutely will not. But I say that it will only increase if it is not put away, if it is not banished, if it is not warred against. For I say you must indeed be willing to stand for the truth, to declare the truth, and walk in the truth. And I say, when my own people will walk fully in the light that I provide, then I say that sin and darkness are put on the run. But I say, when my people will compromise to accommodate sin, to accommodate the worldliness that is all about to live in the darkness, I say they are literally inviting their own damnation. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do not call my people to be stupid, to be dull, to be dumb. And I say, when indeed my people fail me, they are meant to repent. That is, they are not meant to go on in their own headstrong ways, determined that they are right when they are wrong. But I say, they are meant to be coming forth, uplifted, directed, and ever guided by me. and I say they are meant to be given the truth and the light, the purpose that I provide. Now I say, therefore, this day, be glad that you can indeed look to me, believe upon me, and trust in me. That is, that you can be brought forth in the blessedness that I provide each and every day. For I say, if you really consider what a privilege it is to trust me, to believe me and hope in me, then you are guided by me. But I say, if you are hoping in the circumstance, if you are hoping in darkness, evil, and iniquity, I say you are hoping in lies. Now I say, this day, when I, the living God, do give to thee the truth, the light, and the mercy, I say, be thankful for the same. That is, be thankful each day that you have been given the privilege to repent and to walk uprightly in me. For I say, when you really look upon the sin cursed and you see the darkness, the evil, the iniquity that they are literally the slaves of, and the bondage that they live in day after day, I say it is only a fool who returns to sin. For I say, when a man has been set free and the demons driven from him, and he allows those same things to return, I say they come multiplied. And I say that his sorrows are intensified and his grievous existence is more wretched than before. I say this day, do not, absolutely do not, be envious of the wicked who want their own way. But I say instead, be thankful for the truth, the light, the strength that I give unto thee. And I say, be glad that you can be brought forth, knowing that in thee you are given the blessedness, the truth, and the mercy time and again. That is, you are given the way wherein you can walk uprightly in that which I, the living God, do give to thee. Now I say, therefore, this day, be glad that it is me that you can continue to look to, that you can continue to believe, to trust, and obey. And I say, be thankful that I will purpose thee in that which I intend for my own. For I say that I will bring forth, I will direct, and I will correct the people who cleave to me. That is, the ones who are ever present, giving me thanks and praise. Now I say, this day, when I, the living God, do give to thee instruction, I say, pay heed to the same. That is, be ever willing to accept my direction, my correction, and my instruction unto thee. And I say, be willing to bend the knee, to bow down low, and humble yourselves before me, that you are guided forth in my life. For I say, if my own people would truly be in obedience unto me, then it is me, the living God, who can change the world. That is, I can cause men to desire righteousness once again, if my own people will obey. But I say, when the ones who are my people are ever living in disobedience, are ever flirting with the filthiness of the world, are ever closing their eyes to sin, I say they are ashamed to my name. And I say, it is me, the living God, who turns them over to the wallow, the filthy mire that they desire, and I say they will perish in that. For I say, when a people will name my name in fraudulence and claim they are serving me, yet yield continually to sin and darkness and evil, I say they are literally not of me. But I say they are of their father the devil, for that is who they serve. I say this day that I, the living God, do not call thee to serve darkness, not in any of its disguises. But I say that I call thee to serve me in truth and light, in mercy and hope, each and every day. And I say that I call thee to be made glad, ever thankful, that it is me who are privileged to love, to serve and obey and follow after. And I say that I call thee to be thankful that it is me, the living God, who is ever present unto thee. Therefore I say, continue ye as a steadfast people, who are ever believing, receiving, and walking uprightly in me. For I say, when you cleave to the way that I offer, the way that is truth and light, the way that is mercy and hope, then you are guided forth in me. And yes, you are given the blessedness, the truth, the light, the strength that I give each and every day. For I say, it is a good thing, a sweet thing, a blessed thing to be brought forth by me. That is, to be given the strength of the truth that I give thee each and every day. I say, therefore, be thankful to perceive, to receive, to come forth in what it is that I give thee time and again. That is, the way of eternal life, the way of hope intended, and the way that I provide for my own. And I say, continue in the way of repentance, revolution, living in, declaring, and walking in the same day after day. I say, give thanks, give praise.
Cry aloud, do not hold back, lift up your voice like a trumpet.
declare to my people their transgression, the house of Jacob their sin.
The times of ignorance God overlooked, but now he commands all people everywhere to repent.
Live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.